you, AG sir. Thanks a lot. I'm really thankful to Ajipal sir and Dr. Anand Sharma and others that they have given me an opportunity to speak on a very important topic, that is the changing dynamics of employability skills. Let me start my slides. Dear friends, I hope you all are able to see the slides. The title, it is very relevant as per the present scenario because you all know that we are going through a pandemic situation of COVID-19, and it is one of the topics which is really of high importance to all the interns, students, scholars, outgoing MBA outgoing students and others. So that's why I have chosen this topic, and I hope you'll find something relevant to your need and demand with this time. So as you are seeing, you are hired, a wonderful thing. Everybody is very much happy to see this thing. And what is employability? The employability is the capability of gaining and maintaining employment. And all the efforts are done by the universities, colleges, individuals, just for this very purpose. So what are the employability skills on which we people are working for so long till this point of time? You all are aware with those skills, like soft skills, as has been discussed in the morning by Dr. A.P. Sharma, and then key behaviors, competencies, which are talked by one of our speaker on the very first day by Professor Wolfram, learning skills, then personal, generic skills and basic skills. These are something on which people are learning or working for so far. Then why there is a situation on taking a title like changing dynamics of employability skills, if skills are known till so much of time? The issue is, this topic is a topic of discussion in the present scenario, because there are so many things which has changed in current 3-4 months. As is visible on the screen, that apart from grocery stores and online sellers, the job market has crashed and will not revive, at least for some time. The competition for available jobs will be greater, with applicants needing to distinguish their skill sets beyond academic capacity. Why the competition is more? That we'll discuss in the coming slide. Internships, often a key to employment, have been stopped due to this COVID situation. And practice co-ops and field placements have been stopped, even though organizations are trying to find some other ways to employ the students or interns. Universities are also working in the same direction. But definitely things have changed, and it will take a time to come to that stability position. Some industries are cutting back. Interviewing industries are cutting back, that you have seen. There are some industries which are really not doing something good or great during this time, like automobiles, like hotel, tourism, and so many other industries. So there's a need to think on this employment scenario. And again, interviewing will be virtual and will require a different way of presenting oneself than in person. And you know that first impression is the last impression. So you need to work on all these things to come up with this situation. And definitely in coming time, degrees will be of less importance than demonstrable skills, including skills like soft skills, adaptability, resilience, teamwork, and other ability to communicate effectively in this virtual and physical environment. So my dear friends, these are some of the issues which are drawing concerns of the academicians, of the individuals, to go through this very topic. So what will be the status of employability post-COVID scenario? You know, now we need to start thinking from global to local. Why? Because it's almost impossible for you to have an international tourist visits to other countries for at least for an year. Then what do these tourist ports will do? what do the people who are engaged in tourist organizations do to learn their earn their livelihood? So they need to start thinking from global to local. Instead of providing the global packages, they need to enrich the local destinations and provide jobs to the people there. Again, so many people have come from different countries to their own countries, and they are also a competitor to the existing workforce. And then what are the different types of skills which are required for this changing time for jobs? Are these skills are there with the people who are fighting for the jobs, or they are with the people who have come from other country? Because now time is of the type that definitely everybody is looking for a job in their local areas, in their own countries, at least for 1 to 2 years. There is a tough competition. Why? Because jobs are less, and definitely this COVID situation has led to so many other organizations also to cut down the jobs. So it is the demand of a time that the organizations, few type of sectors are almost completely shut down. Then what do those peoples will do? So there is a tough competition due to less number of jobs. Changing organization structure and culture. This is something wonderful. One of our panelists on the first day, she spoke about the positive things which are coming out of this challenge. And one of the positive things she discusses is like that people start working with the flexible working hours. They work with the remote accessory hours, and the work style has changed. Definitely the organization structure has also changed. In fact, government organization has done very well in spite of the fact that people are more reluctant to change. But this is the situation where everyone has to change, to adjust. An organization structure maybe in coming time will totally change. More flexibility is required with the changing dynamics of organizations. High expertise, instead of looking for a specialization of a task, that we are looking for only a mechanical engineer, only a electrical engineer, or only an IT expert. We need somebody who has almost a knowledge of so many things. So multitasking type of sort of things will be there. More of the jobs will be of consultancy types, part times, and something of that sort, with the reduction in job, and everybody need to adjust themselves to those. So a high level of expertise is required. When we are talking about large number of skills, definitely digital skill has taken the way. It is something which has played a very important role to come up with this situation of COVID. And we all know that it is because of the digital knowledge that we are in a connect. Still, we are in a connect with everybody. In fact, we make a more access to the people to whom we are not always being in touch in such rigid organization structure. Again, digital skills are something which gives a fast access to your work, one-to-one interaction, more visibility, a best visualization of the things. So this is something which is very important, and maybe in coming times people need to upgrade themselves with this. Commercial skills, dealing with the situation, people and all, and data analysis. Yes, of course, my dear friends, it is one of the wonderful skill and important too, because what we are looking is like this is the only skill based on which a lot many jobs are coming in future. So this is my suggestion to the listeners, that we need to develop these skills, because the coming time is of more of IT and digitalization than that of a manual or a traditional methods to deal with the situation. So large number of skills are required, and we need to be ready to upgrade ourselves accordingly. And definitely there would be certain sectors where you will find more of the job opportunities, and there are certain sectors where there will be a less number of jobs, or maybe there are more number of cuts in the jobs. So IT sector is one where there would be a huge amount of hiring. So we need to upgrade ourselves. IT doesn't mean only computer knowledge or not. Yes, of course, your basic knowledge is required, whether it is related to medical, whether it's related to engineering or anything else. But other than that, you have an IT skills to deal with the situations. Consultancy sort of jobs will definitely come up, or I can say being in HR language, that more of an outsourcing job type of jobs would be available as compared to that of the traditional full-time jobs. So we need to be more master in skills to survive. Otherwise, you know, Mendel's principle, survival of the fittest will work in coming time, and the one who will not fit for this environment has to go. Healthcare sector is a huge, a very big sector with a huge number of opportunities. As I was listening to the speech of Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi, and he is talking about the Atmanirbhar concept, and he said that we need to turn up this time of challenges into an opportunity. And to your surprise, what I'm observing, that healthcare sector is the one which has definitely grasped this time as an opportunity. While going through the list of MACs and all, you know, earlier there was a hotel business, there were separate industries and separate business for sanitization and others. But when we go through the MACs hospital list, I've analyzed, they have collaborated with so many things, and they have startup as a good package for healthcare sectors. Healthcare insurance are also coming up. Healthcare is a big, a huge field full of all future requirement and responsibilities, so that you'll find a lot many opportunities here. Again, manufacturing, definitely with this COVID time, you have observed that so many people, they are, what I feel personally is like they are basically two type of jobs. Either it's a manufacturing sort of jobs in the coming time, or that is pure manufacturing base of sorts, because most of the people belong to villages. They migrate to their own villages, and they are also looking for a job. So it is the responsibility for government to generate jobs for these type of people in their own villages. So purely into manufacturing, like processing, these type of rural industries will come up, agriculture, manufacturing, and some sort of those sort of things where you can find a better opportunities for jobs. Otherwise, healthcare is one. So basically, there would be a two type of job combination in coming times. One is purely of manufacturing sort of things, and other one is more digitalized, more of data and more of IT sort of things. So these are two types of skills we need to focus. And based on that, what is more important is we need to start focusing on our students in that manner, that we have to pay more attention on the vocational training. For the people who are from average knowledge and background, they can do much better in manufacturing. And the ones who are highly educated, we need to make them more specialized, multitasking with the IT knowledge and all, so that they can do better in these segments. So increased skilled employees from abroad has also entered to the country, even though they are the own country's people. So in that case, the competition increases for the local people as well, and they need to focus more on what they were doing from last so many years. So this is the industry scenario during pandemic that we have observed. Like, there are hard hit industries or sectors like travel, tourism, almost closed. Now, what these people are supposed to do, they have to find some new ways to earn money. You know, I was just going through one of the social travel videos sort of thing, and it was a wonderful idea being an entrepreneur, because I'm teaching this subject, and I'm the subject is very close to my heart. So whenever I saw something where we can find an opportunity to start a business, it sounds to be very attractive to me. So social travel or tourism idea was good. Secondly, I personally feel that it's now it's the right time to focus on the local tourism. We need to develop the areas in our country. We have a lot many tourism areas which are not developed or explored till time. So within these coming 2-3 years, what we are supposed to do is we have to explore them so that we can provide jobs to the people who are hard hit from this travel and tourism industry. Again, they need to find a new ways of earning money or new ways or new innovations in their own working style to survive. Otherwise, it would be very difficult to absorb these number of people. And what do they do and where do they'll be absorbed if they will not enhance on the existing skill of theirs? Retail is something. Retail is more advanced. Retail has done a very good task in this present scenario. But yes, affected. That organized retail, which was gaining pace as compared to that of local Kirana store, was also hit a lot. So it needs to be revisited to the retail industry. Even though online retails are doing good, but not exactly the extent to which they are supposed to. Then few service industries, they also have faced a hard hit, like hotel, restaurant, gyms. Each of them are equally important, but it is the demand of the time which has pushed them back. So just force them to come forward. What is required? We need to focus on these industries once again. We need to rethink on how they can work better without being in contact, one-on-one contact. Because during this COVID time, we have observed that how other retail outlets or how other service industries are doing in other countries. So we can also develop things to that extent. Some innovations to help these people to work with the way they are into. There are certain sectors that I've already said, like which are working well and have done wonderful during this COVID-19 time. The one of them is the healthcare. And definitely there's a time now to rethink on our country's healthcare facilities. In fact, as it is a point of social concern, we need to pay more attention. Our country government has to take this into revival or revisit to enhance more facilities in healthcare sector where we are lacking. During this time, you'll be surprised to know biotech and pharmaceuticals are doing well, and most of the researchers are trying to come out with some good research related to this COVID, some medicines, some antibodies, something of that sort, and they are also doing good. Like in fact, some special card and tea business is also coming up. So this is wonderful that in almost all of the challenges, we are finding opportunities and we are doing well. NGOs, really, NGOs and government entities have done their task very well during this time. And the NGOs, I'll talk about, like self-help groups, they have done a wonderful job in terms of providing the mass manufacturing, the sanitizers, social distribution of things, involving themselves in so many social work related to this pandemic, distribution foods or providing medicines or something of that sort. Like there is a group in Delhi, recently I forget the name, which has helped the elderly people of families to provide medicines if they are being all alone in some houses. So NGOs have done a wonderful task, and we can thank of enhancing the NGOs also so that in more and more people can be absorbed there. Being from Rajasthan, I know that there are a number of NGOs which are really working very well in different fields. So we can take the help of NGOs also for healthcare and other sectors. Then government entities like nurses, police, and other stuff, they have done wonderful tasks. Academicians have really helped the students in the universities and everybody not to break the chain of knowledge. They have utilized almost all sort of channels to provide education to their students, not to waste their ear. And their contribution is really appreciable, not because I am also an academician, but they have done a wonderful task. And I've seen that academicians really do very well under stress, even though everybody has done a very good task during this stress time. and they have come out with the positive things with time. And in fact, this is again a sort of learning, which we always feel that we are not teachers, we are learners. The more we learn, the more we enhance, the more we adapt, the more we flexible, the more we'll be adjustable to the situation. And this is the demand of the time. And this is what we are looking from our youngsters also. Because if we need to survive, we need to be flexible, we need to be adaptive, we need to be a learned person. And these are some of these skills you need to enhance. E-commerce business has done a very good task during this, and they have hired a lot of people. And in fact, the hiring is going on. So what is the need of embracing change? What is embracing change? So it is something, look for positive ways to make changes. Work rather than identifying why change will not work. So say yes rather than no as first instinct. Adapt to change. The new ways of working quickly and easily. Example, NGOs, healthcare, that I've already discussed. And they have really done a very good task during this time. Make suggestions for increasing effectiveness of changes. Yes, of course, there are organizations and there are people who have come out with the innovative ways for the organizations to continue with the productivity during this pandemic time. Then again, making suggestions for increasing the effectiveness of changes. And this is what is Atmanirbhar Bharat. When everybody starts doing this, will definitely become the self-sustained. And this is what is the demand of time. That instead of looking here and there, we need to focus on what we have, enrich ourselves, and come out with a new spirit and energy to prove ourselves. And definitely will do. Next is show willingness to learn new methods, produce, because if you are not going to do, you'll not be adjustable. And this people have proved during this time that so many people start working with the remote work culture, flexible working hours, flexible shifts, more connect to the people. In fact, in our country, we have less culture of remote work and all. We are habitual of 8 to 5 timings and all, but people have learned a lot and they're flexi and they have proved themselves that they can work in adverse situations also. So shift our priorities from response to the demand of situation. This is the coming time. We need to start thinking based on the demand of the situation instead of thinking what are priorities. We need to bounce back from setbacks and maintain a positive attitude. So now come to the basic thing, that what are the employability skills which actually the employers are looking for during and after this pandemic of COVID-19. So first of all, we need emotional pliancy, stability. Instead of thinking for own, we need to think for group, how we can do better. Technological mastery. In terms of IT skills, in terms of negotiation skills, in terms of management skills. So technological mastery is must now. Nobody can say, I don't know this. No, you have to. You have to know this to survive. Otherwise, you'll be out. You are not the best fitted part of the model. Collaborative ingenuity. You need to be a bit smart how to work in teams. In spite of being away, see, these webinars are a result of this. In physical world, it will take more time for us to collaborate and conduct an international webinar. But with this implementation of technology, time stress, demand for time, we have come out with so many, you know, innovative ideas, easy way to do this, and we are doing it a bit fast as compared to the physical existence of the people. And maybe more easily accessible. Then work efficiency. Definitely we need to work on this because the coming time is of cost cutting, improvement, and all such sort of things. So we need to work on how everybody needs to think. The one who will be hired is the one who can just suggest. Who can suggest that who will be hired?
एक आपको ये फोन कैसे दिख सकता है अभी मैंने वो जित्सी डाउनलोड करके
काइंडली प्लीज स्विच ऑफ योर मोबाइल एंड कम्युनिकेट टू दी दिव्या ऑन दिस So workplace flexibility is something every employer has to start doing it. And now their task has shifted. The focus has shifted. The focus is not on the business of an employee, but their focus is on the productivity of an employee, the knowledge of an employee. Talent management is now taking place. So workplace flexibility is very much required. And this stress time has given us a way to make it more possible. Then time management is definitely must. Self-reliance. Now, the coming time is one where instead of looking for job, you need to be self-reliant. You need to look for freelance work. You need to look for more of being an entrepreneur instead of looking for a job to work under somebody else, because now there would be a shortage of jobs. So it is you and your competency and your ability which will get more jobs, or maybe you'll have more of the jobs are of flexible types.
Live streaming is on.
So, am I audible? Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible. You are audible.
Hello?
Yes, sir, you are audible. Audible.
Dr. Divya?
Yes, sir, you are quite
audible. Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are very audible.
Dr. Ajay?
Sir, you are audible. You are audible.
Hello.
We can hear you, sir. We can hear you. There were some technical glitches. Does this thing go off the network? But now the voice is clear. We can hear you.
Anand ji,
hello.
Anand ji, you are audible, and I just want to know whether there are some questions from the other side or not.
Dr. Ajay. Dr. Ajay, questions. Dr. Ajay.
Yes, ma'am. There are few questions which have come up.
Now tell me the way.
Yeah. So, how we can nirbhar on technology? We had watched also the results of technology in past two sessions. Is it good to depend on technology completely? Do we think technology can replace the classrooms and other things?
Dr. Devya, can't be nirbhar on technology all the time. I don't know what's going on the back of this, but yes, of course, it is everybody you find it is man's mind behind the technology. So instead of saying that we can completely rely on technology, it's not correct. And teacher can never be replaced by online classes or certain sort of things. So, but yes. With time, we need to change. Maybe the adoption of technology is more as compared to other things, and these type of changes needs to be welcome. But we can't be always nirbhar on them, and we have seen blunders of, finally and fully depending on the technology. That we all know. So, is it okay?
Question is in the post-COVID scenario. Mm-hmm. What will be more important in your opinion, a degree without skills, skills without a degree? Please share your
pardon, can you just repeat the second part? Degree without skills and skills without
a degree. Please share your opinion in this regard.
See, what I am observing and what is coming up, skills are important, but this is sure that you can't be skilled without degree. It's not 100% true, but definitely degree is must to some extent. To some extent, because skills are something which is inborn also. You can learn by doing and practice. A degree is a knowledge and understanding. Skills is an application to it. So if you don't have an exact skill to implement that knowledge, then it is worth nothing. So they are related, but skills are a must in the coming time. Otherwise, you can't survive with a simple degree. And that we have already studied in number of surveys in the past. We have an educated workforce, but not an employed workforce, which proves that they have a degree, but they are not capable to be employed due to inefficiencies of skills at all.
Okay. What are the parameters you can suggest to evaluate degree of different universities for job selection?
Can you repeat it again?
Ma'am, what are the parameters you can suggest to evaluate degree of different universities for job selection?
I think it's a very tough question you have asked from me. It is very difficult, you know, to benchmark the universities on the basis of the degrees and the job requirement. Because we have seen even people have packages from IIMs, and there are people who are not employed, have got no employment from IIMs as well. So it is not only the university. Everybody has got good people. What is important is the area to explore. Even if you start providing the best thing to our students, they can do wonders. So I don't think universities are named because of the students.
Okay.
So,
one last question we can take. That what do you think that what will be the future of the education sector in post-COVID scenario?
even though there's a point of worry also, but I don't think that security can ever be replaced by technology. Yes, of course, with the help of technologies, we can be more accessible to a large number of workforce. But teaching this 101 to teaching, physical teaching cannot be replaced with the technology. In our country at least, and in abroad also, because you know, learning it will become monotonous if you go with this type of thing. There is something else which a teacher provide other than a knowledge. So an eye-on-eye contact, a physical classroom appearance is must. You can't remove it. Yeah, blend of both is okay. That is true, that is required, that is important, but you can't replace a teacher because of the technology. And that's what I've already said. What technology is into it is because of the mind of a human being. So, and in fact, that will be harmful for any of the country if they try to replace the teacher with the technology. Blend of both is very important for the healthy environment, for learning. With these type of technological advancement, we may reach to large number of population, the one to whom a regular education is not important. Otherwise, you'll find a number of people doing an e-degree, but they don't have a sense and knowledge to work on. They exactly don't know what they have studied. So, to replace it would be not a bad, a good idea.
Okay. Ma'am, there is one more question which has popped up from an academician, Professor Pramod Nayak. Can you suggest any of these standardization points for the degree of MBA?
Sir, I think I'm not the right person, but yes, of course, being a management faculty, I feel it is not the knowledge that you are providing in MBA. What is must is that is an application of a knowledge. If you are successful in providing an application of a knowledge, I don't think a student will look for a job. Because if they have an application of knowledge, they implement it and they become an entrepreneur. They provide the jobs to other sort of people. So standardization moreover depends on the way the students are placed. Are we be successful in providing whatever is actually required to provide them, or are we are just simply fulfilling the task to give a degree to them? So this is what I personally feel, but not being a master in standardizing and all, I just say kindly excuse me if something went wrong.